This is it.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. You can see. But it was down here.
Anne King is referring to this trunk, or the treasure chest that kept an incredible family story hidden in the basement of her childhood home for years.
But basically, it was sitting in here.
In gathering memorabilia for her father's funeral, Keene learned that his relationship with baseball as a kid went far beyond the old jokes he used to make about hanging with all-stars like Ted Williams and Johnny Pesky.
I realized that it was a bigger story than he had really told. In fact, I don't think he really knew how big it was.
At 9 years old, Jim Raugh served as the bat boy for the Cloudbusters, a 1940s baseball team made up of men training at a World War II Navy pre-flight school at UNC-Chapel Hill. Keene knew Williams and Pesky had played on the team, but it wasn't until she found the trunk that she discovered just how many stars her dad was hanging out with in the dugout.
We found almost 24 Major League players who actually cycled through Chapel Hill, and there's a big difference there, going from two people to 24 players who played for the Red Sox and the Yankees and the Indians and the Reds and the Cardinals. I mean, it was all there, so much bigger than I could possibly imagine. So it was, I don't want to use the word game changer, but it was.
At age 79, Jim Raugh told an audio archivist what it was like getting to hang out with all these major leaguers as a kid.
After practice, we'd always go to the scuttlebutt, which was right behind the ball field. The scuttlebutt is like a snack bar to you and me.
Okay.
That's what they call it. And we'd always get lemon ice cream. Ted Williams loved lemon ice cream, and so did I. And he'd got me a half a gallon or a half quart of ice cream, and we'd sit there and eat it, and we'd talk. And of course, my eyes were bigger than saucers.
Raugh's eyes were big because of the stature of Williams and the other baseball players. But they were in Chapel Hill for more than just baseball. They were training to fight in World War II.
I call it playing baseball fighter pilot style. There were just all these different techniques incorporated for hand-eye coordination, running, just becoming more aggressive, different training measures to toughen them up, not only physically, but emotionally.
Because the team had so many famous players.
Oh, I think that's Garinger right there.
Keene assumed there would be dozens of books about the Cloudbusters, but she didn't find a single one. So she picked up the pen herself, and her book has turned out to be quite the hit.
It was such a fascinating tale. I just really enjoyed it, and I even like baseball.
Pappas might have found it fascinating because the book isn't so much about baseball as it is about a period of history most of us know very little about.
With all the hand-to-hand training, it was constant.
Now, because of Anne Keene's book and her discovery of the trunk, we know much more about the team that helped win World War II.
Families hold these heirlooms, and they're everywhere. They're in attics, they're under beds, they're in basements, in metal containers that one would think are not very valuable.
But oh, how valuable they can be. In Hickory, I'm Payton Walker, reporting.
They went on to have a well-known major league.